Of course, it does depend on the definition of severe asthma. Different are the definitions. As far as now, there is a more common accepted definition by the European Respiratory Society and the American Thoracic Society. And according to this definition, about 5 to 10% of asthmatics can be defined as severe asthmatics. Of course, when we are talking about severe patients, we are also talking about patients who can have some confounder factors, such as comorbidities, relevant comorbidities that may affect the severity of the disease itself, or, for example, lack of adherence in treatment, or patients who are not completely able to use inhaler treatments, and so on. So, in the case you will really address all these confounding factors, probably the prevalence will get lower than 5 to 10%. There is, for example, a very interesting study done in the Netherlands in a population of patients, and when they were really able to address all the confounding factors, only 3.5% of patients can be considered severe refractory asthma, so the real severe endotype or phenotype of asthma. Of course, they can be 3, 5, 10%, and it is anyway a huge problem, even if the proportion seems to be low. Actually, there is a huge problem because they are using most of the health reserves resource called or health-related resources to dedicated to asthma, even if they are a small proportion of patients. Oral corticosteroids in severe asthmatics is very commonly used. Just to tell you a real-life data, in the Italian registry of a severe asthma network, which is the registry of patients with severe asthma followed by reference centers for severe asthma, about 64% of patients are regularly taking oral corticosteroids, which is a huge proportion. And for these patients also, these patients are also taking, by definition, very high inhaled corticosteroids, and often, very often, also intranasal corticosteroids, because they are having pseudonasal comorbidities such as allergic rhinitis, or more often, even more often, nasal polyposis. So the total corticosteroid load is very high, and that's the why it's really a concern, the corticosteroids related adverse events. The most common corticosteroid adverse events are such, for example, hypertension, diabetes, but also local situations such as cataract or glaucoma, or higher increase of a respiratory infection, cardiovascular disease, or osteoporosis with pathological bone fractures. So a huge of different amount of possible comorbidity or possible adverse events that are really relevant in a population taking so high corticosteroid load in their, or even particularly because they are taking corticosteroids chronically.